She clearly inspires you.
Absolutely. She inspires me to get to the gym more often, I'll tell you that much. The essays in the book are all addressed to her. I started doing that actually when she was first born. We had a difficult labor. We spent a lot of time in the hospital, and I wasn't getting any sleep. I had insomnia, and all I had with me during all those hours was a notebook. So I started writing these essays and these thoughts directly to her, sort of as a way, I think, to leave a legacy for something that she'd remembered down the road. And also my wife was a little bit in and out of it, so I wanted her to have something to remember the experience by as well. So I started writing direct to her, and I've just kept doing it all these years.
There's a great photo, and I don't know where I saw it, maybe on Facebook, or I don't think it's in your book, but a great photo of you and your dad back in Buffalo when you were just a little bean yourself. I think you were sitting on a dock. Tell us about your father.
Yeah, my dad. My dad was, I come from a long line of steel workers. All his life he worked at in the steel plants in Buffalo, New York. That's where I'm from originally. My uncles were all steel workers. My grandpa was a steel worker. So we come from that sort of SDR, Democrat, blue-collar family, blue-collar background. My dad was not a man of many words. But when he did say something, you listened. He was an outdoors guy. That's where I sort of got my love of the outdoors from. We had every year he would rent this cabin up in Canada with his brothers and the family, and all my uncles and aunts would go up there, and we'd spend the week out on the lake fishing. I hated the final result of fishing. I wasn't big on actually catching the fish, but I loved doing it because I loved being out on the boat with him.
You became a dad, I think, after 40. I'm being generous, or maybe I'm not. I don't know. But I can see that you are totally immersed in fatherhood, and I'm wondering if you were concerned as you passed through your 20s and 30s that it might not happen.
You never know that you want to be a dad until you're a dad. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
My wife and I both became parents a little later in life. I appreciate you being generous and saying after 40 as opposed to almost 50. But, you know, we had some prior experience with Aaron and Janelle, the two kids that we became guardians to for a few years there, and that's a whole other story. So we had some experience with the 8, 9, 10-year-olds there for a couple of years. And it sort of that experience drove us to want to have a kid, you know, to want to have our own. Because, you know, it's a lot, you know this, I'm not telling you anything you don't know. It's a lot of work, but there's a lot of satisfaction that comes out of it, too. It really opens your eyes to a new kind of world, seeing the world through the kid's eyes. And
I'm really curious, though, about the day that Uma reads the book that you wrote to her and about her and how she'll react. And then will she read it again when she goes away to college? And then will she read it again when she becomes a parent? I'm really curious to see how that turns out.
Boy, I'm curious too. a friend of mine, a very wise friend of mine, whose kids are a little bit older, told me that parenting is like a 30-year construction project, right? So for the first 10 years, you build the foundation and you build the house for them, and then for the next 10 years, during their teen years, they tear the house down, and then for the last 10 years, the 20s, they rebuild the house on top of your foundation. And I really like the implication of that. At some point, she's going to be her own person. At some point, she is going to, you know, when she turns 13 or 14 or whatever, she's going to have probably earlier by, you know, at this point, but she's going to have her own social media, and she's going to Google her name, and she's going to scream dad from her room, you know, when she discovers how much I've written about her.
We're out of time, but I want people to know that tonight, Wednesday, people can virtually connect with you and hear you speak.
Yeah, so I'm doing a couple of events before Father's Day. Tonight is going to be the Concord Library, and that is going to be a Zoom event. It is free, but you do have to register. So Anybody can either go to the Concord Library website, or they can go to my website, or find me on social media, whatever, and we'll send them out a registration form to register for that event. And also, this coming Friday, I'm going to be doing an, also doing a Zoom event for Freethinkers Corner Bookstore out in Dover. And that's a similar situation. You can attend for free, but you have to register, and we'll be doing a reading and talking about fatherhood. And I think both events will be great fun.
Dan, happy Father's Day, my friend.
Happy Father's Day to you, too, Mike. Thank you so much for having me.
You're welcome. We'll talk soon, Dan.
All righty.